lot of them have never seen the gorilla. So this is from MSNBC. This isn't some, you know, crazy creationist site, you know. This is from a lot of different sources. From Discover Magazine, what an interesting admission. This is not a magazine favorable to creationists. It said, she erased a line between past and present. It was a dangerous discovery. Here's what one guy said, one scientist. I had one reviewer tell me that he didn't care what the data said. He knew that what I was finding wasn't possible. I wrote back and said, well, what data would convince you? And he said, none. He refuses to see the gorilla. What happened to the dinosaurs? Was it smoking? You know, there are a lot of scientists who don't think that the dinosaurs were wiped out because an asteroid hit the planet 60-some-odd millions ago and killed all life. First of all, dinosaurs just don't vanish from the fossil record. Geologists will also tell you that that site doesn't really look like a crater impact. So many scientists know that dinosaurs didn't die this way, so they've come up with a lot of silly theories over time. And I'm going to show you those. They're pretty interesting. Bill? That one needs more volume. There we go, that's as high as I can. The Death Star. So one theory is that there's a sister star to the sun that spits out comets every 2-3 million years, and that's why the dinosaurs don't suddenly vanish in the fossil record. There's different crater impacts that cause them to go extinct. Cataracts led to blindness. Shrinking brain, stupidity, they were too dumb to live. Chronic constipation. Another scientist said, well, no, overeating. And another guy disagreed with him and said, no, starvation. Poisonous plants. Mass suicide. I never really understood that. I don't know if they found a bunch of fossils at the bottom of a cliff and just assumed mass suicide. Dino wars. AIDS. That's one of the more recent ones. And this last one I just heard on O'Reilly Factor about, what, 3 months ago? Global warming is what killed the dinosaurs. So what really killed the dinosaurs? The ones we find in the fossil record? Well, if you've got a global flood that buries a lot of things all over the planet, I'd say that's what happened to the dinosaurs. However, would there have been dinosaurs on the ark? According to Genesis, there was. Of every living thing of flesh, two of every sort that shalt thou bring into the ark to keep them alive with thee. They shall be male and female. They were on the ark and they came off the ark. Dinosaurs survived the flood. Did the ark look like that? No. We need to get that out of our churches, because a lot of our churches display that. It portrays it as a myth, as some fairy tale. Using the dimensions in the Bible, that's what the ark looked like. And by the way, the dimensions in the Bible, if you ship architects in South Korea, experts in their field, use the dimensions of the ark in the Bible, and they could not capsize the boat. They amplified the tsunami that occurred about 5 years ago. They amplified it like 5 times the amount, and they could not capsize the ark. It's a perfect description of a boat that's built for stability. It's interesting that all the cultures around the world have flood legends, flood stories. And they've also got accounts of an ark. And when they do that, it never matches scientific data. For example, the Babylonian account, it was a cube-shaped boat. It was several stories tall. Can you imagine being in a cube-shaped boat for a year? It would spin endlessly. There's no way you could survive. Again, here's its size. And you know, we could actually, creation scientists have conservatively estimated that you can populate the earth with all the animal kind we see today, with 16,000 animal kinds on the ark, and they would only occupy 15 railroad cars. Here's a common straw man argument that evolutionists love to use. They say, how did Noah get millions of species on the ark? Species is a man-made term, okay? You don't need to take the 15 different North American jackrabbit species on the ark. You only need one rabbit kind. They got classified as different species because over time their population separated. It's called allopatric speciation. And they developed different mating habits, so they wouldn't interbreed. But you know what? They find out if you give them enough time, you put them back together, they'll interbreed. They're still rabbits. You only need one rabbit kind on the ark. There's a lot of genetic variability in the genes of animals, and you can produce a lot of variety of life in a very rapid period of time. That's what happened with Darwin's finches. Yeah, there was variety, but guess what? It happened too rapidly for it to be evolution. It was genetic variability, and it can't possibly be evolution biologically. And another point I want to make is, how did Noah get, giraffes and the big dinosaurs on the ark? Well, you don't have to take big animals, right? Dinosaurs are lizards that, lizards tend to not stop growing as they get older. They can get really big, especially if you had a really good climate. So why take the senior citizens on the ark? Sorry, Ed. You don't need to take the old animals. You can take the younger animals. You can even take dinosaur eggs. There's plenty of room. You didn't have to take big giraffes having their heads stick out of the portholes. So again, we covered that, and I wanted you to see what it looks like compared to a large cruise ship. And here's the Ark compared to the Titanic. Of course, the Ark fared much better. Okay, let's look at some of the illusions of evolution. There's things like science versus religion, small change lead to big change, ape men, fossil record. We're going to talk about all of these. The illusion, definition of illusion in the dictionary. This is interesting. A misleading image presented to the vision, something that deceives or misleads intellectually, or perception of something objectively existing in such a way as to cause misinterpretation of its actual nature. I really think Merriam Dictionary should just use the word evolution there. Because that's exactly what evolution is. Exactly. Precisely describes evolution. So I mentioned the evolution versus science ploy that they use. Every time you read about some discussion,